Okay, anybody, any more questions? That koi puchho us bidan ne koi kahe. Okay, no questions. So let's try, at least we will read this Vachanamrut, which is the very dear Vachanamrut to Kakaji, which is Gadra, middle 25. Those who have their phones or whatever, you know, you can open up that. I will read in English first and then in Gujarati. A renunciant who harbors worldly desires and a householder who has no worldly desires. The title is very interesting. Renunciant who has renounced the worldly desires but still harbors, not giving up. The householder who has the whole world, he is always in the middle of the whole world, but he has no desires, worldly desires. On Shravanvadi 6, Samvat 1879, 8th August 1822, that's like some 196 years ago, Swami Sri Sahajananji Maharaj was sitting on a large decorated cot on the veranda outside the south-facing rooms of Dada Khachar's Darbar in Gadra. He was dressed entirely in white clothes. At that time, an assembly of munis as well as devotees from various places had gathered before him. Addressing all of the Paramhansas, Sriji Maharaj said, "Please listen. I wish to ask you a question. First, suppose there is a renunciant devotee of God who is strict in the physical observance of all religious vows. However, within his heart, he has an intense desire to indulge in the sense gratifications, vishayas. Nevertheless, he does not physically succumb to those desires. Such is the renunciant. Suppose there is also another devotee who is a householder. Physically, he has close contact with both women and wealth. However, in his heart, he is free of worldly desires in all respects. The question then is, what will be their fate after death? Will they both attain the same status? Or will one become superior to the other? Please consider the distinctions between the two and give an answer for each separately." This is like a question paper. Somehow Bhagavan is putting a question paper. Thereupon, Gopalan Swami, the head Paramhans, replied, "When the renunciant passes away, dies, because of the intense desires of his heart to indulge in the sense gratifications, God will make him a wealthy householder, either in this world or in the heaven, where he will attain an abundance of sense gratification, vishayas, to indulge in. In fact, in the heaven, he will indulge in vishayas, sense gratifications, like those of a person who has deviated from his spiritual endeavors, as described in Bhagavad Gita." There is a question. question by Arjun to Lord Krishna in Bhagavad Gita 5,000 years ago. That one who has focused to become renunciant, but either his time runs out and he dies, or his focus changes and gets again tangled into and then dies, what happens to that person? And Lord Krishna promises that one who has started walking on this roadway will never perish, will never fall down. Yes, it will take longer if the diversion is there, but Lord Krishna has promised, you know, Nahi kalyana krut kaschit durgatim tata gacchati. The one who has walked on the roadway, he cannot fall down. It is protected and guided by the divine power. And then Lord Krishna is answering the next life, you know. And it says, Prapya punya krutan lokan nushitva shashvati samaha. Suchi naam srimatam gehe yoga brashto bijayate. So there Lord Krishna is saying that person will take a birth into the very rich family, just like Gopan Swami is explaining. And Gopan Swami is the Chetana, the soul of Lord Krishna. He is saying the same thing that he said 5,000 years ago to Swaminarayan Bhagavan. And he says that the person who did not finish the task will take a birth in a very spiritual family, very rich family, and there his journey will be continuously going on and he will finish it. So that is the answer that Gopan Swami said, referring to Bhagavad Gita. Then the other part, the householder now. What would happen to the householder? The Gopan Swami's answer. On the other hand, when the householder devotee passes away, because he is free of worldly desires, he will attain the abode of God, Brahmapur, where he will reside at the holy feet of God. As far as the aforementioned renunciant is concerned, when he becomes satisfied after indulging in the sense gratifications, he will eventually develop vairagya, renouncement, towards them. And then, feeling guilty in his mind, he will engage in the worship of God. Thereafter, he will become free of worldly desires and attain the abode of God. So both eventually would go. One would be on a local train, the other one on a rocket speed. So this is the difference. Hearing this, Sriji Maharaj commented, correct, that is exact answer to the question. Very few times Swaminarayan Bhagavan has said this in this Vachanamrut, that this is exact answer. There is always something Bhagavan would add, God would add, you know, and hence. But here he is saying that yes, that is the correct answer. We are going to the last paragraph, you know. Kakaji has referred to the last paragraph. We are still in the middle. Then Muktanand Swami asked, if one has such a strong worldly desires and wishes to eradicate them, by what means can they be eradicated? One who has a strong worldly desire, either householder or renunciant, and wishes to eradicate them, that I don't want it. But it is like somebody who is a smoker, you know, has a smoking habit. He wants to quit, but his habit is not allowing. I have seen many people, you know, that they have a long cigarette, right? They would puff 2-3 times, and then they have to go to the place where they cannot smoke. So they would throw, like they hate it, you know. But they had puffed, you know, 2-3 times. So you can see in their reaction that they don't want to do that. They are knowledgeable that it will cause them cancer, cause them sicknesses. But it's very difficult to quit. Yesterday, we were at the motel in Springfield, our Bhavin Bhai's motel. So I was sitting in the car, and there was a couple. There was a man and woman, you know. So woman was sitting on a outside bench. And very nice people, you know. And then this man who was smoking just gave his cigarette to her. And she started puffing. And I was thinking, you know, that both of them know, you know, that it is bad. It is bad for their money, their wallet. It is bad for their health. But they cannot quit. It's very difficult. So here also, that a person who would indulge in the sense gratification, once gains the mature understanding, then would think that this is not for me. I am better and different than this. But the bad habit is not letting it go. Bad habit is not allowing him to swim. So Muktanand Swami asked the question again. If one has such strong worldly desires and wishes to eradicate them, by what means can they be eradicated? And very simple answer Swaminarayan Bhagavan has given. Sriji Maharaj replied, just as Uka Khachar, one devotee who was in Garda, just as Uka Khachar has become addicted to serving the saints, addicted to smoking, same way addicted to serving the saints. In the same way, if one becomes addicted to serving God and his saint to the extent that one would not be able to stay for even a moment without serving them, then all of the impure desires in one's inner self will be destroyed. Very simple way, right? Just attach. Just be crazy for something. And be crazy for this, that you want to be in the service. So this is the middle question. Now the last question that Kakaji normally refers to this. Then Swayam Prakashanand Swami asked, Maharaj, by which means is God extremely pleased? What can we do that God can be extremely pleased? Sriji Maharaj replied, if a devotee who once had only 20 kilograms of grains in his house for a whole year, 20 kg of grains. I think we have talked before, right? That if you divide 20 kg over the 365 days, how many per day? Divided by 4 or 5 family members, how much per person? Divided by 3 meals, how much per meal? Maybe 10 or 5 grains every meal, right? It would be less than the mukvas. And there are poor people like that also, right? They barely make it, right? So, Swaminarayan Bhagavan is saying, if a devotee who once had only 20 kilograms of grains in his whole house, in his house for the whole year, were to attain the sovereignty of a village, now he becomes the owner of the village, or the sovereignty of 5 villages, Chicago, LA, New York, Houston, you know, owner of those, maybe big villages bigger, or the sovereignty of 5 villages, or the sovereignty of 50 villages, or the sovereignty of 100 villages, or even the sovereignty of the entire earth. And if after this he remains just as loving and humble with the saint as he previously was when he was poor and submissive, And if he remains just as humble, even if he were to attain the kingdom of heaven, Indralok and Brahmalok, then God would be extremely pleased upon him. So no ego and full of humbleness, right? After having all these powers and amenities. But it is very rare to see that kind of person. Our Narendra Modi somewhat fits into this, that he is Prime Minister of India, but he is still very humble. He folds his hands. Even his opposite party, he is not criticizing negatively. It's, you know, admirable. So that is one part. Swaminarayan Bhagavan said, this is for a householder to how to behave. Now for a renunciant, how to behave. Because the original question started with two group of people. One was the renunciant, one was the householder. So how the householder should behave, that is what it said here. Now for the renunciant. As for a renunciant, even after attaining powers similar to those possessed by God, if he can continue to manually serve all saints in exactly the same manner as he did when he was new and timid and not attempt to impose his authority upon other sadhus or try to compete with them, then God would be extremely pleased upon him, the other side. But you can understand that saint has more powers than that householder. Householder is just the owner. And this one is owner of the owner. That is the power a renunciant would get. So that is the Vasanamrut, Gadra Vasanamrut, middle 25. And it's 10 o'clock. Sajanand Swami Maharajni, Jai Jai Jai. I was going to read in Gujarati, but next Friday maybe we'll read and do something. And if somebody wants to work on that and come with preparation, it's fine too.